on.
Hello, my name is Laura Allen and I've just finished a Master's in Clinical Research at City University of London. I'm currently working at St Thomas as the Research Physiotherapist. And I spent the MRes looking at the support needs of people who've come home after a critical illness and particularly what patients identify as important. For me, we get it wrong, so we don't prioritise the same problems as patients do, and so we occasionally give them the wrong support and support that isn't important to them. I spoke to 12 people, so I did telephone interviews with a group of people I recruited through a charity and a patient and public involvement group, and they described four main themes. The first was managing their transfer anxiety, and transfer anxiety is something that's spoken about more commonly from people who are discharged from critical care to the ward, but it also happens when people are discharged from the ward to home, and that sudden loss of care that you get monitoring can be very frightening for a lot of people. That was exacerbated by being discharged very, very quickly, sometimes with no warning. The second one was tailored information provision, so people wanted to understand what had happened to them, how long their recovery might take and what they could do to make it better, and also where they might be able to get help. And for a lot of people, they weren't getting that information. Timely access to services was really important. So I heard stories of people waiting 9 months for counselling, very, very long time for physiotherapy in the community, and quite often GP exercise referral schemes. So for example, a 40-odd-year-old woman being referred down that pathway and finding herself in a group of old age, much older people who weren't using the service in the way that she needed to. And lastly, a supportive social network. So not just friends and family, although friends and family are very important. People talked about their carers as being very important in their motivation and encouragement, but also peer support groups and that sort of thing. So the real take-home message for me is that as physios, we need to be very good at making sure people are signposted to the right places so they know how they can self-advocate. And you do that by giving them written information because people don't remember verbal information. And also that follow-up clinics have a really important role in helping to navigate this system, but they need a little bit more flexibility. So for a lot of people, happening at 3 months is too early, for some it's too late, and for some coming to the hospital is just not appropriate. So being able to build in more flexibility in those models is really